what we're calling phase 1C medical conditions include the following. So we are adding these to the medical conditions that we have already used. Type 1 diabetes. Most people develop type 1 diabetes before age 21 and are completely dependent on insulin therapy from day one. In contrast, type 2 diabetes is more common among adults and is largely accounted for by our age-based approach to vaccine eligibility. So at this point, type 1 diabetes, we were requiring that someone had been hospitalized. We no longer require that. So anyone with type 1 diabetes. Next. Women who are pregnant. Obviously, the age group does not cover them. And we felt that it was the right thing to do to cover them. You have two lives at risk. And Dr. Vanderhoff will kind of explain the medical situation in there. Again, no one's required to take this, but this is a group that we are making eligible today. The next group, the third group, those who have had bone marrow transplants. A bone marrow transplant, a treatment reserved mostly for people with certain cancers, anemias, and performed at specialized transplant centers. Again, Dr. Vanderhoff will talk a little bit more about that. Finally, we are clarifying that ALS or Lou Gehrig's disease is a qualifying severe neurological condition, even though its age of onset may be quite variable. It was the intent to include ALS. We did not spell that out. We are spelling that out today in response to some questions that I have received. Again, these are medical conditions that increase the risk of severe outcomes or death from COVID-19, but aren't covered in our age-based approach.